So I'm definitely watching Tesla tomorrow. I'm definitely watching Amazon tomorrow. I'm definitely watching Facebook and Alibaba on dips. I'm definitely watching Microsoft tomorrow.
Welcome to Access a Trader, the number one community for those who are committed to taking control of their trading in order to achieve success, profitability, and longevity. Thank you for joining us. Here's Dan Shapiro to help you find your edge, master your process, and own your future.
Hey guys, good evening everybody. Welcome to another edition, the Wednesday edition of the AccessATrader.com nightly wrap-up show. How are you? Hope everybody's doing well. So, if somebody went to ask you, okay, what does win look like, right? We know what win feels like. We know the ramifications when wins get very, very aggressive. And before we even go on, I definitely want to say a prayer, and I want to keep everybody in my prayers tonight for all you guys who are affected by Hurricane Laura, the Texas, Arkansas, Louisiana area, I think some of the parts of Florida as well, all that region, okay? We definitely, all of us in the Northeast and the West Coast and Mid-America, everybody sends all positive good vibes to you guys, and we want to make sure that you guys are safe. So maybe describing what the wind looks like, maybe it's a bad analogy, but I think you guys got to get the point. So if somebody turned to you today and asked you, well, what the hell happened today? Okay, what was the action like? What was the aggression like? It's very, very tough to put into words. For all you guys who didn't trade today, okay, if you guys remember on last night's video, especially the little intro prior to this little video that you're watching now, I was very, very bullish going into today. We talked about the video last night, you know, about the sleeping giants possibly stretching, okay? We got a lot of clues yesterday. So I was very, very prepared for today's session, incredibly prepared. We talked about Amazon, Tesla got a $2,500 upgrade today from Jefferies. We talked about continued to be strength in Facebook and in Alibaba. I said, hey, Roku, any day now, it's going to wake up, right? So we were very, very prepared. Unfortunately, there's no way I could possibly describe to you how aggressive today's session was, okay? I don't think we saw a downtick in some of these names for like 3-4 hours, okay? What I saw today from Netflix especially blew my mind. I mean, completely blew my mind. And when you look at a consolidation, the first candle on Netflix was $35, okay? Like $35. And then the next $5, $10 candles were like nothing, well, $30. Amazon went ballistic, Tesla went ballistic. And again, we'll get to the individual pivots in a second. But, you know, as much as today was fabulous, it's very hard for me to describe what happened today. Just an incredible day. But I want to take a different approach, okay? I don't want to talk about how great the aggression was today. And today was probably top three biggest aggressive days that I can remember, okay? I want to kind of shift little gears and speak to the newer traders, the traders who are trading for less than 5 years. And, you know, as much as a lot of people caught a ton of this move today, and when I mean move, I mean plural and different beta names. Unfortunately, a lot of new traders, whether they trade with me, whether they trade anywhere else, you're going to miss a lot of days, okay? You're going to miss trades that most traders that are trading for at least 7 to 10 to 15 to 20 years are going to capture. And the reason is I keep on reiterating this point all the time. The first 3 to 5 years, you still have your training wheels, okay? These are facts, okay? As much as you think you know what a chart looks like and what sentiment looks like and understanding technical analysis, again, the one common denominator every trader has from the first day that you open up a trading account to kind of year five, and year five is kind of like the turning point, okay? The one thing, you're not emotionally, you're not mature enough to understand all the moving parts. Now again, you'll never understand all the moving parts because again, there is no end game. We talked about this many, many times. I still am shocked from time to time what I can figure out or what's in front of me that I didn't even know existed. So it's a never-ending game of continuing education. So you're never going to understand everything. But once you hit like year 5, year 7, year 10, you got a good grasp. Unfortunately, the first 3 to 5 years, you got your training wheels on, like I said earlier, okay? You're not emotionally steady. You still have, you still take to heart losses. You still don't fully embrace that losing trades or losing days or losing weeks, whatever the case may be, is all part of the business, okay? So when you are faced with a really big premium day, and again, the first clue today was there was a premium day. This was, I literally put all beta. There was literally all beta today. Once you see all beta on the pivot feed, you know there's gonna be huge value, right? Huge value today. Don't anticipate waiting for confirmation. So you could be literally dealt when you're the age of, you know, the early A stages of 3 to 5 years, you could literally be dealt aces, okay? And you're gonna screw it up, okay? Just because, again, your maturity level, not in terms of years of being alive, but in terms of being alive in the trading business, you're still an infant, okay? You're still a toddler. You're still a newborn. You're still trying to figure out how to crawl. You're still trying to figure out how to, you know, take those first steps so you can walk. By the time you're 5, you're 6 or all around, you start moving a little bit faster. But these are your maturing ages. This is your maturing stages. This is where your nurturing comes in. So the idea that you are mentally ready, okay, to not overthink, to not take everything personal, to capture the greatest measure potential you could possibly happen. It's impossible to put that much pressure. And I saw so many people talking about on social media today, oh, I missed this rally. Oh, I can't believe I missed this rally. And then my question was, well, how many years are you trading? The person say, well, I'm only trading for a year and a half. You're supposed to, okay? You're absolutely supposed to. The first 3 to 5 years, you are completely trying to embrace everything that's going on around you. You're trying to understand the moving parts, and there's thousands of moving parts. So the idea that you're going to maximize playing aces, okay, is ridiculous. And I just want you guys to know, and again, a lot of you guys who are watching this broadcast fall into that, you know, 1 to 5 year time horizon. And I want you to understand this. It's okay to miss big expansion days, okay? It's okay. You're gonna mess up everything. I still mess up things from time to time. It happens, okay? Unless you're a computer, unless you're a robot, you're a human being, you're gonna mess things up. So I get that a lot of you guys did incredibly well today, but I do understand as well, because again, it's part of the game, it's part of the business, it's part of the steps to kind of longevity. I get a lot of people miss this as well. Before you beat yourself up tonight, just take a really deep breath and just listen to what I'm saying, okay? It's normal. You're going to be okay, okay? It's not, you're not going through anything that every trader walking the earth hasn't gone through. And I'm telling you, the most important part is keep working. Screen time is your ultimate champion, okay? It's your absolute ultimate champion. Eventually, after screen time kicks in 7, 8, 10 years, okay, trading the markets is going to be as comfortable for you as brushing your teeth. These are facts, okay? Don't let social media tell you you don't need any experience, any money. You need a lot of experience. You need a lot of money, okay? You need a lot of screen time. And eventually, it's all going to click, okay? So don't put unnecessary pressure, okay? Don't try to learn everything and, you know, anything that the 20, 30 year career will give you in 6 months, okay? Just take it easy. Day by day, trade by trade, ask a lot of questions, keep grinding, keep looking at charts, you know, make your mental edge stronger, okay? Every day that goes by, it's gonna make it much easier. So again, guys, don't put that pressure on you. You got this, okay? You got this. Every trader I know has started out exactly the same way. You got this. Believe in yourself. Don't cheat the process. Steps by steps, day by day, okay? You got this. You're going to win. But again, don't deviate. For whatever your style of trading is, don't deviate. Keep on going forward. So let's talk about today, okay? And I'm going to try to describe to you what win looks like, okay? Yeah. So one of the more aggressive days I can remember probably in the last 20 years, okay? What I saw today was like watching unicorns dancing in your backyard. It was like watching a UFO land on your top of your house. It's just unbelievable, okay? And the candles that we saw today were so exaggerated. And if you saw the action today, if you followed the action today in the options market, you would think today was the last day to buy stocks. Okay, today was literally the last day. Today was literally the last bet you're ever gonna make for what's gonna about to happen in the future. And amazing. It was simply amazing. And let's talk about this. So you guys know it, man. I've been talking about this Roku for 3 weeks already, okay? 152 area, we've been talking about nonstop. 52 rejected three times last 2 weeks to reclaim, upgraded this morning, $180 price target. I thought at one point it was gonna go to 180 on one candle, okay? Any close above 154 is bullish. Now again, you could be ready for the day, you're not ready for what we saw today. I don't think there's one person on the planet who thought, you know, this was gonna happen today. And they just started going, guys, one by one by one. So here was Roku. I did very well with this trade. So here is the whole channel here. Just went nuts. Just absolutely went nuts. 52 and a half, 53. I got long at 53. Just exploded. Went right to supply at 167. Again, it's very rare you see a $15 candle put in on Roku. But again, this is what we tried to explain. It's trying to explain somebody what win looks like. Again, just insane. JMIA, again, not a really big deal. $11 rejected twice. It went up like 20 cents. I don't even want to talk about these things. DKNG, again, 4020 needs to build. It ran up like 50 cents. Who cares, right? We're talking about beta, okay? Shop, 1050 needs to build. Again, one by one by one by one. So here was 1050, okay? Here was 1050. This whole range here is 1050. Ran up to 1115. Insane, absolutely insane. Amazon, oh man, when I'm telling you they were coming for those 3,400, 3,500, 3,600 weeklies today, they were coming for them. Monster, absolutely monster. I thought at one point it was just gonna literally go to 3,500 today. I still like everything tomorrow, especially on dips, but 3,365 needs to build. Here was Amazon, right? Here's the 3,365, right? 3,365, it took that out. Took out the previous week's high of 3380, what traded as high as the 3450. This thing looks like it has 3500 written all over it. Alibaba was a pivot towards late in the day. It went from 291 to 292. Again, most of the day it was in the red. Zoom, you know, we talked about potentially getting that 300 level. Here it took that 300 today. 294, 296, big levels. Needs to build. Here was ZM, right? We even talked about ZM last night. So here is the whole area right here, this whole channel. 94 was right here, 96 was right here, ZM went to 302. But again, ZM was like a yawn fest compared to everything else. Tesla, huge, absolutely huge. 2063 build, experienced traders only. Again, do I really even need to say experienced traders only? Guys, there's so much value out there. But again, if you fall into that area of 3 to 5 years, 1 to 3 years, just leave Tesla alone. It's just not for you. There's so much better value out there. But again, 2063 needs to build. Tesla went absolutely bananas. Again, insane. So here is 2063 right over here, right? The whole area here, 2063, and you know, went to 2170, only 100-point move on Tesla. Facebook, again, just monster. Facebook, 284.50 needs to build. So here was Facebook, right? Here was the whole 284.50 area. Look what this Facebook did. I mean, this thing went to 300. We saw 320, 350 calls coming in. I'm talking about short-term expiration. Violence. I'm talking about the violent of all violent option markets that I've seen today in a very, very long time. Microsoft, 218 needs to build. Microsoft exploded. Again, a lot of call buying came in. Again, here's the 218, right? 218, 52-week high, went to 222. I still like this thing, just a huge move on Microsoft. FSLY never gave a second entry. The first move went to 92.75, 93, went to 93.50. It retraced, it just never took out the second value. But again, the key to the game was what we talked about last night in the video and this morning. It's a huge value day. I go, do not anticipate, wait for confirmation. Things just went out of their minds. This is my first comment, just huge open. It was a huge, huge open. No matter what you traded this morning, was an absolute huge open. Roku, Tesla going nuts, Shop going nuts, Microsoft new highs. I mean, you could just tell them one by way. Facebook going nuts. This one, again, didn't give you a second entry either. 1840, 1850 needs to build. I think it ran up to like 1880 and then reversed. Again, beta was the goal today. ZM300. Twitter actually gave a trade, 4085, 4081. Traded to like 4130s. A lot of call buying came in. But again, not beta. This is, again, why we talk about when beta is in bloom, this thing is no joke. Amazon 33.65, and this was the big number. 33.90 was the top of supply on the 60-minute channel. I said 33.90, this thing will erupt, yada, yada, yada. Went to 34.50. Just an insane day. I mean, literally, oh my God, right? Oh my God. I mean, literally, oh my God. Just crazy stuff going on here. And this was a kind of a big deal. And I wanted to really make everybody understand. We've saw this. Well, at least I saw this already, okay? I saw this during .com. I know eventually, okay, whether it's tomorrow or 3 years from now, eventually this whole euphoria is going to end, okay? The only difference is I'm much more experienced now than I was in 2001. So I know how this is going to end. So it's incredible. So I said these are unprecedented moves today. If you're going to be long overnight, make sure you book at least 80%. At least 80% of your profits. There's nothing guaranteed. Okay, worst case, you could always buy stock. So I hope everybody listened to me. Just an insane day today. That's the only thing I can say, only way I could describe it. I think going into tomorrow, look, Amazon, you don't have to be creative. If we get a week open somehow, Amazon, Facebook, Alibaba, right? Microsoft, Zoom, anything that's beta, if they give you a dip open tomorrow, okay, into rising 60-minute support, you have to buy them. If you trade beta, you have to buy them on that rising 60-minute support to trap late shorts. Red to green, obviously, is on the table as well. Just understand, red to green is not a pivot. It's just momentum. So that's very, very important for tomorrow. Okay, that's kind of like almost like the brainless way to looking at tomorrow's session. But you have to start looking at names that haven't really erupted, okay? Or just sitting there for an extra couple of days of consolidation. Let me give you guys some ideas that I like for tomorrow. Look at Disney. We started seeing really aggressive 135 call buying, okay? Very, very aggressive. It starts taking out this top of this channel here, it's going to go, okay? It's going to go. Maybe it woke up today because of the whole streaming thing. Roku woke up. Netflix woke up. Disney, I definitely like Disney for tomorrow. Definitely keep an eye on it. I like this NET. Looks interesting as well. It's gotten rejected here several times here on the top of the channel. That looks good. Names like Nvidia even. And again, it's not like Nvidia hasn't had a big run. But Nvidia is kind of just sitting here in this really, really tight channel. So I'll definitely be watching Nvidia as well. And I'm definitely looking for... I don't want to use the word laggards because some of these names have had big runs. I'm just looking for the ones that have kind of been tired for the last 2-3 days for them to wake up as well. So what can you say, guys? Have a great, amazing day. I know a lot of you guys did incredible today. You're blessed. God has blessed you in so many ways and nothing to do with money. Guys, God bless for all our friends in the Texas, Arkansas, Louisiana area. May God bless you, keep you safe. And God's willing, I'll see you all in the field tomorrow. Take care, guys.